Okay guys, I'm just gonna fly through this because it should be pretty self-explanatory. So, and this is for a couple of local guys, for anyone else watching, you're welcome. So, the magician's kitchen here, obviously you have the sun well in the center and you have the cauldrons right here, and you can see the kind of mist coming off them, and you can see the kind of mist coming off them, and you can see the kind of mist coming off them, and the cauldrons right there. So they, in a way, in this, they're a bit like pedestals right here. So much going on here, I won't be able to cover it all, but you've got the edifice here, I'll show other shots, and you've got the orb, the fireball in the center, and the well, you can see the etheric swirl right there, just so many things, the little alcoves around the outside. Oh, also just the there's a lot of alchemy kind of tied in with this as well, if you will. These characters here are pawns, and they are holding up, in this case, a piece of the mushroom right there. And this is going to throw a lot of people out because they think this is all to do with the drugs. But so the mushroom right there going into the, that's going into the center here, okay? This is into the alchemical center. So this is all to do with the etheric energies going into the center of the magic ritual right here. Here's yet another shot of the board game, and you can see that you have, so you've got fire there, earth, water, and air represented here. You've got, they've all got orbs there too, so you can see the particular orbs placed. This would be one of the pawns right here. We'll show further shots of that. You can see the incoming and outgoing, and there are magnets under here, I'll show that too. So the energy is going in and around and into the center here. You can kind of see the sunwell aspect to it too, as you can see on the Masonic floor. Here's a close-up shot of the pawns, like as if we're talking about the pawns on the chessboard right here, holding up what would be the orbs would go on here, those little balls. The elemental orbs, so they would hold up the elemental orbs. Magician's kitchen here, and around there you can kind of see, just get a bit of a close-up here of the alchemy sort of shown in there. There you can see the four orbs around the one, the fireball in the center with four air, water, earth, and fire, and they are holding up the orbs there. I've never really gone into the symbology, but anyway, I like this particular shot of the board because it kind of has the sun well there, just with the lighting and all the rest of it. In this shot, you can see the child's hand here with the magic wand as part of what's going on. Just further within here, also, of course, with these four parts coming down here, you have what is kind of an etheric dome, if you will, fiery etheric dome with the four rivers coming out. In this case, it's kind of like a lava flow type setup. Yet another shot, just having a look through here, there'll be all sorts of things people can pick out. I don't really want to baby people here. So guys, this is a web page, and there's a couple, they're talking about two magnetic games, are probably from the same company, but here's another shot of it right here. And you can see various things happening with the flames there, with that sort of flow in there. But anyway, so lighting the fire in Magician's Kitchen. There's this article right here. Now, interestingly, this person in here, for whatever reason, so magnets are fun to play with. There's something almost magical, okay? I know it's scientific, like almost magical. Kind of interesting here, anyway, about the way they push and pull, especially when the magnets are hidden. And it's going on here about a magic labyrinth. We'll just go down further on this page. So that ball there, that would be the central, that ball there, and you have many depictions of orbs within scenarios, and I've shown this all before. So there are various balls, but anyway, so that would be the one marble, I think, in the center there, the fireball, as they put it, which goes up and down in the center there. And four wands, fireplace, references to magic. For a moment, this is the bottom of the board, and inset are magnets into the bottom of the board here that trip the pawns up and so forth during the game. So I don't want to go through all this, but this is the sort of basic outline of the game, and there will be heaps of bits and pieces within here. So, and within here you can read, After you have delivered all four of your ingredients, earth, air, fire, and water, you get to take the fireball, the central orb, the four around the one, from the fireplace archway, so that, like the dome also, and deliver it to the fireplace, lighting the flames. Do that successfully and you win. And there will be heaps of innuendo and all that sort of thing regarding magic through here. So Magician's Kitchen came to my mind when I was looking at an old video, which we're just going to go to in a moment, that regards this, that's alchemy as well, and the analogy of the kitchen. And this is no doubt Masonically driven in this case. Not to say that it's particularly Masonic, this is magic practice, but so we'll go now and look at this cartoon. Okay, this is from Cookery Nook, an old cartoon, 1931, an archive about dried fruits and eating healthy, advertising. Jachin and Boaz, the veil going through, the person is the pillar entering into the edifice right here, and then we're going to go into the kitchen. A Commonwealth government production, we'll just go through here. The four around the table right here, and Mum's offering the young son here. Look at his eyes, sort of interesting, but not just for my fascination right there. But we'll just go through this further. So here's Mum, small character on the floor here. She's now miniaturized on the book right there. And this is from the sun. So she's now within the central beam of the sun here, which is an etheric beam, and she is getting information through from that. And there she is there with this spell to make here, an alchemical spell. So there's the gargoyle right there from the pillars, the people as pillars. So she's coming out of the people. So you got to sort of get with the program on this. And mixing up, so other ingredients into the center here on the checkered floor. Notice the etheric nature of the bowl. You can kind of see through it. So more like a gargoyle coming from the mouth. Everything like dragons and everything, all these are creatures, it's from the mouth. Everything like dragons and everything, all these are creatures, it's from the mouth. 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 It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case. It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case. It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case. It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case. It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case. It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case. It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case. It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case. It's sort of stretching out from the etheric pillar in this case.
And now, a tablespoon of jam. May I suggest you use apricot? A beautiful bunch of grapes, sun-dried into 1 ounce of lovely sultanas.
All right, so the beam again down onto the that central, that sort of central bowl there, that central pillar right there. That's all the central pillar. It's all the central pillar. It's all the central pillar in the center of the man of the Masonic floor.
Mixes it with the best of a
friend.
Pour the mixture into a well-greased
tin
and cover with
greased
paper.
The pot. An anthropomorphized pot assisting here. The pot, I guess you could think of it with the stars and all the rest of it. So speeding up of time, which is interesting. I know it sort of works, but the speeding up of the clock, distortion of time. Now the back around the table here, and of course this would be earth, air, fire, and water, and all the rest of it. Okay, so in this scene you can see the washing with the central beam on the Masonic floor, and these would be the elementals perhaps going through in this case. Now into the sun well right here, into the pool, the water, with the archway at the center here. You can see this lately with the archway. Oh, the speeding up of time here. Very good example. And then out of the archway right there also, out of the sun well, sorry. Out of the portal in the center of the Masonic floor, believe it or not, they just can show this stuff and it's unbelievable to the public. Well, it's not believable at all. In fact, it's not even seen, not noticed, not nothing.
are now the perfect Christmas tree. 1 pound in butter.
So another recipe going on here, another ejection from the mouth, like a dragon, like a, or basically, you know, these etheric creatures.
One pound of flour, 1 pound.
Like a gargoyle.
Add 1/4 pound of ground rice, 1 teaspoon of baking soda.
Okay, we'll just go now to, I'll just speed it up to the last scene. And in the last scene, here you have male and female around the central pillar right here. So in this case, you see this everywhere on shields with the male and female cherubim, I would deeply suspect, at the sides of the central pillar. Very classic.